By default, the Linux Mint Mate panel is located at the bottom of the screen. If you remember way back in video 1, we saw Ubuntu Mate show the panel at the top of the screen, which is the Mate panel default. The Linux Mint version of Mate has the panel at the bottom of the screen. If you want to move the Mate panel to the top of the screen, you can hold down Alt and using your mouse, click and drag it up to the top of the screen. We can also move it to the left or the right using that same method of holding down Alt and clicking and dragging. I'm going to place back onto the bottom. There are a few default applications on our panel, and we'll talk about them in a moment. Let's first look at the panel properties. And to do that, I've got my arrow on the panel, and I'm going to right-click and bring up Properties. The first thing we see is the orientation. It's at the bottom. We can change this to the top, to the left or the right, or back to the bottom. That's what we just did using our arrow. We can also change the size. If I make this 0, it shows us a minimum size of 21. If I change this to 500, it gives us a maximum size of 180. Now these numbers may change depending on the version of Mate you're using and your screen size, somewhere around 20 to 150. I'm going to make my size 25. The next thing we see is expand. That will make the panel go all the way from the left side of the screen to the right side of the screen. If I uncheck this, we see it shrinks down the panel and puts it right into the middle of the screen. And I can move this to the left or the right by grabbing these end caps. I'm going to expand mine back out. Then we've got Autohide. That makes it disappear when it's not in use. Since we've got the panel properties open, it is in use. I'll need to close this to see it disappear, and there it goes. To bring it back, I move my arrow down to where it is, and the panel comes back. I'm going to turn off the auto hide and turn on the show hide buttons. These show up at the ends of the panel, and even if we uncheck expand, we still see those buttons. They're little arrows right now. If I uncheck the arrows on hide button, they turn into little buttons. Clicking that hides it to the right. Or I can click the other one, which hides it to the left. Same thing when it's full panel. I'm going to uncheck that and go to the Background tab. The default is None. Use System Settings. We can change this to Solid Color. I will make the color maybe a dark blue. Then we can also change the transparency of it. Make it transparent or opaque or somewhere in between. I'll go probably 40% transparent. If we had a background image we wanted to put in, we could use that. Let's turn this back to None, use System Theme, and close. Going to right-click on the panel, and now I'm going to add a new panel. We see the new one is added to the top. Adding another one adds it to the right. Now we've got one on the left, and if I add another panel, we see it's added at the top again. I can delete this panel, delete this panel, delete this one, and I'll delete this one as well. If we come down to this main panel, we are not allowed to delete the panel. If I add a new panel, now I can delete this bottom panel. So there has to be at least one panel, and it doesn't matter where it is. I mentioned some default apps on our bottom panel. Let's try and put them on our new top panel. I'm going to right-click, Add to Panel. The first thing we want is a menu button. We want the mint menu. We can click on it and click add, or just double click on it. And it's added to our panel. The next thing we have is the show desktop. And there's show desktop. It's moved to the left of it. I'm going to right click and move this over to the right. And I'm going to move the menu all the way to the left. Now I'm going to move the show desktop to the left. If we have some programs open, maybe something like the calculator and a text editor, we see these showing up in our bottom panel, but we don't see them in our new top panel. To add them in, I'm going to check our items, and down at the bottom we have window list. Adding that shows the open windows. We also have a window selector. That doesn't show anything unless you click on it. Shows the open windows, and we can select the one that we want active. Perhaps I want the calculator to be active, or the text document. Now I'll go back to the panel. Over on the far right down here on the bottom, we've got a notification area. If I add that in, notification area, we see it got added in by these three dashed lines here. If I right click on it and click on about, it shows us notification area 1.8.1. I do not know how to add things to this notification area, like the update button, the volume, or the time. We can add those in as separate items. Adding in the clock, that looks similar to what it is at the bottom, but I don't see a way to add in the update manager or the sound icon that we have down here at the bottom. I'm going to remove the top panel now. Delete this panel. It's asking me if I want to delete the panel and its contents. Yes. And I'll need to reload the panels for my working panel at the bottom. I want to add a few programs to my panel. Accessories, we'll add the calculator to the panel, add to panel. I will add the text editor, add to panel. And how about under Internet, Firefox web browser, add to panel. If I want to change this order, and actually I do want to have the calculator open and the text editor open again, because we want to see the open windows as well. Now I want to move my Firefox over to the right. So I'm going to click move, and just moving my mouse moves it to the right. Notice when it's to the right of the windows list, it kind of crushes that down, and I can't move to the left. I can't move to the left of it because the show desktop has the lock to panel on. I'm going to unlock it so I can move this one around. I'm going to move this to the far left, and it's not allowing me to move that because we have our windows list locked to panel. Let me unlock that. Now I can move this over to the right. Move our lock to panel back over to the left. Move the Firefox browser to the left. And I also want to mention that if we click and move, when I hold down shift and move it, it moves the icons to the right. Now I've got shift held down. Let's move this back. And also when I have shift held down, it will not jump over or switch places. Let's move this back. I'm holding shift down. and move, pressing Shift. Now if I move this Firefox browser again, move, and I'm going to hold down Alt. When I move it to the right, it moves all three to the right. When I move it to the left, all three go to the left. So Alt does work differently than Shift. Now I'm just switching from Alt to Shift, and we can see that it does not move the icons to the right, back to the left when I hold down Shift. So I'll right click, move, hold down Shift to keep them in the same order. Right click, move, hold down Shift to keep it all in order. Close these, and we're done. If you like these videos, please tell a friend.